Hi, my name is Adeshewa Josh. I'm a broadcast journalist. I'm also a community development strategist. I run an NGO called the Project Smile Africa. We reach out to young girls, teenagers basically in rural communities. We mentor them. We also help them in terms of education and social welfare. On a day-to-day basis of work, a lot goes on basically in the newsroom. The newsroom is aka the madhouse. As much as possible as a journalist, you're laden with the responsibility of telling the stories, untold stories, to the rest of the world. So when I come to work in the morning, or should I say when I wake up in the morning, I catch up with all of the news headlines. So it's like I pop up, oh, thank God I'm awake. I pick up my phone, what's trending? Because I am an international affairs correspondent, I go first online. What's happening on other media sites? I look at CNN, I look at the breaking news, I look at all of these stories. And then I say, okay, this is what is happening. Then I get to the office, I look at the local stories and find a way to sometimes find a balance between these stories. And then I have an editor or the head of my desk or my other colleagues, and you throw the stories out there and say, look, this is what is happening. How do we bring this story to our viewers? Now, I'm talking about our viewers because I also host a program called Network Africa. It talks about stories and headlines across Africa. I love everything about my job. As a journalist, we want to ask those questions, find answers, and help every other person who is trying to find a solution, connect them with the answer. So you have a problem, you help people find the answers, or at least something close to the answer, connect the people, connect the solution, and those who are responsible, and leave them to make up their minds. That can be a beautiful thing. You feel like you're adding value to humanity, and you're helping communities grow. What are the challenges when you keep looking, and you keep looking, and you don't find anything? It can be frustrating. You know, when you spend years looking and pressing on a demand. Now, you've got to be careful because in journalism, you have to shield yourself from putting in too much of your opinion into your stories. And that, worldwide, is a difficult thing to do because sometimes you have to empathize to be able to get a story out there. So say, for example, there's lots of robbery in a place and your brother was killed, or someone else's brother was killed. How do you tell that kind of story without so much emotions? Because you do know you've lost a member of your family to the crisis. So you begin to tell a story more passionately sometimes than you should. But at the end of the day, you want to put the facts out there and let the people make up their minds. That is a big challenge. Everywhere you go in the world, because the media is saddled with telling every story that exists. And I don't know if we have enough manpower and if we have enough human capacity to do it. But when you go everywhere around the world, they will tell you the media isn't doing their job enough. So I don't think in that regard Nigeria or Africa is an exception. But I'll tell you some of the mitigating factors. You would know that we live in a society that still isn't fluid with information. So, for example, we have the Freedom of Information Bill, which has not been ratified by all of the states in this country. And I want a certain information about some monies that were spent in a particular state. I would spend, if not years, months, asking that particular department in a particular state to give me the whole of that information. If I go online, it is probably not there. Want to compare these people. You know, also when we compare America to Nigeria, that's about more than 100 years, or should I say 200 years democracy. A lot of things has evolved in that country. And we are just 50 years and barely how many years of stable democracy. I am not saying that we are the best thing since sliced bread right now, but we have a lot to challenge ourselves with. So we're not where we're supposed to be. But are we sitting down and resting on our oars? I've never met any journalist or any of my colleagues who feel like, oh yeah, we're there now. No, I don't know anybody like that. So as long as we want to keep improving and getting better, we're gonna get better eventually. I've heard so much about you. You want to be a journalist. All you have to do first is look within and find out what makes you different. What makes you different is what is going to put you out there. Then begin to put in the work. If the work doesn't come to you, go and look for it. Ask your editors, ask your lecturers, ask them to send you to places people do not want to go to. Find your style. Love it. Work hard. Read. Listen. And they say the sky is just the beginning. I think the sky is just going to be your abode, you know, indeed your beginning. And then you begin to soar higher from there. Again, find out what makes you different. Work hard and embrace your style. I am Adeshewa Josh, and I am the Nigerian Media.